group discussion, a buzzword to get selected or get into the top notch. Whether it is MNCs, whether it is companies, whether it is colleges, you have to crack a group discussion in order to get through. Group discussion is a means to prove yourself through your communication skills. I am here to discuss the do's and don'ts of a group discussion. It helps a trainer to screen the right candidate among the pool of candidates. So here I am to discuss the do's and don'ts of it. Firstly, make sure your first impression is well planned. The first impression goes a long way in establishing your credentials. So your entry is very important. If you are the first speaker, understand the difference between starting and initiating the discussion. Initiating is about imparting an overall direction to the discussion and panning out an agenda for the group. Starting is merely speaking for the sake of speaking. Speak with a concrete plan and direction. This may give an impression to the panel that you are speaking and not adding any value to the discussion. Next, don't be like Arnab Goswami, if you know what I mean. Try to respect freedom of speech of others. Speak and let others speak. Don't be arrogant, aggressive, or in vain. It shows that you have poor interpersonal skills. Avoid folding your arms, your legs, to slip into an over-casual position. It is a formal occasion and you cannot portray an informal or casual appearance. Next, encroaching on your neighbor's private space while making a point is a violation of their intimate space, which will be seen as a breach of conduct. So let everyone express their viewpoint. Maintaining a balanced eye contact. So don't look at only the key speakers in the discussion. It is your responsibility to glance at all the members of the group. The key speaker should definitely be given more attention, but this should not imply that the passive speakers are totally neglected. Don't form unions, cartels to visibly monopolize the discussion. This is seen as an act of violating the essence of an open discussion. This also projects you as a person vying for undue power and control. Next one. Getting restless and jittery when someone counters your point shows that you lack patience. It is natural that in a discussion, your point too will be contradicted. You are supposed to respond with fact and figures, examples and illustrations. Don't get into unnecessary arguments or futile conflicts with other speakers. Use a strong voice, clear diction and correct grammar. This gives you an operational advantage. Next one. Try to bring in more and more people by your side. Eventually, the discussion boils down to group dynamics and collaboration. Moving on to the do's. Do take counter arguments gracefully and display good listening skills, projecting yourself to be a good listener. Next, acknowledge the previous speaker before putting across your own viewpoint. Do support your viewpoint with examples and statistics. These will always add conviction to your point of view. Demonstrate your ability to look at a topic from multiple dimensions. This reflects your ability to think laterally and treat the topic in a more mature and wholesome manner. Do try to understand the right exit points. Please appreciate that the challenge is not to hold the main stage all through, but to add value at appropriate points of the discussion. Your exit strategy is as crucial as the entry. Do recapitulate the main points of the discussion when required. This helps to consolidate the flow of the discussion at the critical points and also demonstrates your ability to assimilate the viewpoints of others. Next one, Do present yourself as a team player with an ability to balance individual excellence and group performance. The group discussion is not just your perspective. You have to respond to others' perspective as well and enlarge the whole scenario of the discussion. Address the members of the group with utmost respect and dignity. This shows professional courtesy and etiquettes. And lastly, when asked to conclude or summarize the main points of the group discussion, then just don't give your viewpoint. You have to present what did the group feel about the topic as a whole. I hope this session will help you to face any group discussion with confidence and ease in the coming future. Do revert back to me about your opinion regarding this session. I'll come back to you with another informative session. Write to me and yes, be glued. Thank you.